morning. Thank you so much for inviting me. My name is Dr. Caroline Hermione Karus-Ons. I am the Deputy Environmental Commissioner at the Ministry of Environment, Forestry and Tourism in Namibia. Thank you for having me. Director of Ceremonies, Ditch Plastic Network, esteemed representatives from different countries, esteemed members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It is my distinct honor and privilege to be with you today at this international conference on the digital innovation for circular plastic economy. Since this conference will look at how digital technology can be used to address the management of recyclable waste, mainly plastics, it has provided us with this great opportunity by bringing together different stakeholders from the political sphere, academia, and the waste management industry to deliberate and develop innovative solutions that can drive the circular plastic economy in Africa and across the globe. Waste management in particular is embedded in 8 of the 17 Sustainable Development Goals. This is a clear indication of the importance and relevance of how initiatives such as Ditch Plastic Network can contribute towards the management and addressing of climate change. Ladies and gentlemen, the digital innovation for a circular plastic economy, in particular, this network and conference comes at a time when the world is still trying to address and reverse the impact of COVID-19. The pandemic itself could in fact have contributed to an increase in the production of waste globally. This is evident in the material used to produce rubber gloves, personal protective equipment, and other materials. As a result, we as environmentalists need to develop innovative ways to manage waste and implement strategies that embrace the digital sphere in management over a long term. Currently in Namibia, there is an under-exploration of waste management opportunities and a circular economy that is able to eliminate waste, maximize value, and create space for job opportunities that allow for repurposing and reprocessing of plastic waste. In addition, challenges and opportunities exist in plastic waste management from a pan-Africanist and national perspective, such as inadequate funding, transportation, and infrastructural development, which would accelerate creation of adequate formal waste collection systems and technologies for effective waste management. Ladies and gentlemen, an opportunity worth noting is that Namibia has implemented various national cleanup campaigns and awareness campaigns focused on the reduction and recycling of waste. As the Ministry of Environment, Forestry and Tourism, we will continue to strengthen awareness creation to effect behavioral change amongst our citizens around waste management, especially on the foundation of the youth. To achieve this, working with our industry partners and other relevant authorities have become imperative. As an example of digital innovation and environmental management, Namibia launched an online application system for environmental clearance certificates in 2019, which means that we have entered the digital transformation. Digital innovations make processes more rigorous, efficient, transparent, and client-friendly. We thus look forward to the expansion of such innovations, particularly in plastic waste management, to create a circular plastic economy. Ladies and gentlemen, this is but one of many lessons that can be drawn from Namibian experience to be explored by other institutions, including governments, academia, industry, multilateral agencies, and other organizations. I commend the industry, mostly local authorities and government ministries, more particularly for being involved in waste management and for their effective and efficient management of various waste, despite the challenges that we are facing today. Despite these difficulties and challenges we are facing as a continent in Africa and as a country ourselves, we need to always remember that invention and innovation are known to thrive during times of hardship. That means we need to continue developing, strengthening digital innovations and interventions to ensure that the lives of our people are imposed and improved through circular plastic economy. Ladies and gentlemen, in my conclusion, I would like to thank Ditch Plastic Network and its partners for the active engagement and collaboration with the Namibian government and other countries represented here. It is my hope that we will continue to share, exchange ideas, and further engage in our future collaborations. I thank you.